Hey guys, what's up? Doug here at Tricker King. Hey, it's been a minute since I've been on video, but I wanted to talk about something here today. I have the new Sen Racing HL150 to talk about with you guys. We're going to be doing a lot with this, and I actually have the B50 here in a second I'll talk about. It's really the same thing, though, primarily just different bodies. But yeah, so this is the new truck from Sen Racing, and what we're going to do with this one, I'll talk about it again in a little bit here, but we're actually going to be taking this out to our next race with the B50, and we are going to have a bunch of our drivers race them, freestyle them, get some, you know, impressions on them. We're gonna run them really, really hard to see how these things are. And also, if you wanna see pictures, actually, of what this comes with, like an unboxing, I have an article on BigSquidRC.com. I will link that here. And that is where you can see the unboxing, the full unboxing for both of these trucks, as far as the pictures go and what's included. I'm also going to be doing a written review in a couple weeks for BigSquidRC on these trucks. But the video review is going to be here on the Trigger King channel. So that's what you can expect coming up here with these trucks. So anyways, this is the HL150. This is a truck that I was very excited to get my hands on. You know, these things have been making the rounds at the various monster truck races around the country, the RC stuff. And we hadn't seen them yet. None of the Trigger King guys had. So these, actually, I just unboxed this. I'm basically just messing around with it now here. You can see here the HL150. It's got that cool body on it. It's a replica of the Hyperlube Annihilator. Looks really nice there. It's pretty well detailed. All right, but let's talk about what's under the body. That's more important, right? All right, guys. Now, I suck at these kind of first impressions unboxing kind of videos. There are better ones out there you can watch, but I'm more the running guy. But let's talk about it here. So Hobbywing ESC, you can see there's a 550 can motor that's crammed in there. Initial impressions on this, by the way, this is really impressive. It's sort of a mid-range. It's like bigger than a Wheelie King HPI, but it's not like a normal 110 scale, like an SMT10. I'll show you what it looks like compared to one of my SMT10s here in a second, but it feels very high quality. This is actually the first Sen Racing product I've ever had my hands on. It feels substantial. The plastic kind of feels like that RPM style, really nice chunky plastic. You can see here, look at the center pumpkin axles on it. Shocks feel good. It's got aluminum caps on it. It's nice. I think the thing I really, really like the most on this, though, is look at those sway bars. This thing, you're not going to be able to really see that, but these are beefy sway bars that this come with, front and rear. Even the SMT10 does not come with front and rear, only the rear. These are really nice. It feels like this truck will stay kind of planted, you know, during the corners. It's a short wheelbase, so that's going to hurt it just from that standpoint, but the sway bars are really, really nice, and they're actually set up like a real monster truck. You know, one of the big critiques I had of like the Wheelie King, or heck, even whenever I built a TXT1, was those goofy sway bars that they had on the four link bars, the bottom four links. It's not really a sway bar. These are real sway bars though. Really, really nice. Hey, you can't really see it here because it's zip tied in, but what the heck, you're gonna have to take my word for it. And you can see it, they're kind of, it has Deans plugs. It has Deans plugs pre-soldered. As someone that puts Deans on everything, all my trucks have them. It's nice to not have to do it, you know, anymore. Everybody uses like the proprietary, either the Traxxas connectors or the EC3 connectors. It's nice to have Deans, so all my batteries, everything are just ready to go right from the get-go. You can see here too, these body mounts are adjustable, which is really nice. Coming up on BigSquidRC.com, I'm gonna be featuring this in my Monster Truck Madness column. I already test fit some different bodies from J Concepts, from Parma, and it's really neat. A lot of stuff fits this. Stuff made for a Stampede especially fits really well, but also some Clodbuster stuff without any modification. That's nice. So it's nice that it has adjustable body mounts right there. So if you're gonna put a different style, you know, where you gotta raise the back a little bit higher than you would the front or vice versa, you can just do it without needing any, you know, additional posts that you have to buy. Back battery mount's high up here, but it's got a nice beefy mount on it. Servo here, you can see chassis mounted, comes down here, a little linkage. So the right there, you can see that, that's how that works. Again, it's a Savic servo. I haven't tested it out yet though, so we will see in the the review. I'll do a full, you know, basically a synopsis on the servo, because these trucks need good servos, right? Luckily, this one being smaller and lighter, and the tires don't have foams on it, more of that in a second, it should, I'm hoping, be able to turn well. And then of course it servos up here. It's protected. Yeah, and it's up by the sway bars here. These sway bars are beefy. I know it's tough to get in there. There's a lot crammed into this truck. And the transmission on it mounted low. That's like right over here. So I guess the last thing on it, the tires, the faux beadlock here. These look really cool. As you can hear, no foams in them. Truck's light though, shouldn't be a big deal. And again, there's a lot of aftermarket stuff. You could do like 2.2 aftermarket. I know Proline has some stuff, J Concepts has some stuff. That would fit this truck really well. You know what? Also, it comes with a wheelie bar. Both of these trucks, the B50 and the HL150, they come with a wheelie bar. I don't have it on there yet. I'm going to have that installed for sure. You know what? Let's talk about the B50 as well here. All right, guys, this is the B50. Again, it's the same truck. It is just, it has a body on it that's different. And hey, as a cool aside, this body was actually designed by one of our racers, Michael Arndt, who's a, past Trucker King champion and who's an awesome racer. Well, you know, the races with us a lot of the time, not as much as he used to, because he has to make a drive down here. But Michael's an awesome racer and he does a lot of bodies for the full size monster trucks. He actually designed the original concept for this. So it's really cool that one of the Trucker King racers actually did the concept for the real truck that wound up being used. So nice job, Michael. But yeah, anyways, the B50 here, again, it's the same truck, it's just a different body. Because this body has these accessories, like these hard plastic things on it, it feels a little heavier and it definitely feels top heavy. So if you're wanting to run the truck stock, the HL150 is probably the way to go. But it does look cool. And again, all the stuff that was red on the other truck is orange here. Looks really nice. Let's do a size comparison with the HL150 and an SMT10. All right, guys, as you can see here, sorry to get it all on the camera here trying. This is my Nuclear Banana SMT10. This is the HL150. Now, you can tell that the SMT10, especially this has the J Concepts Renegades, the bigger tires on it. It's definitely a bigger truck, but this one still is not that small. I know some people were thinking originally, myself included, that it was pretty small. It's not. Again, it's like a middle ground between a Wheelie King and the bigger stuff like a Clod or an SMT10. Good size though, but yeah, that is the comparison on it. And again, on BigSquidRC.com, I'm gonna do some full comparisons. And I'll put bigger tires on this as well so you can see what it looks like. There are already pictures of it out there with Renegades on it, but it'll be interesting to see what else can fit on it. Just a different view here, you can see kind of the size difference of it. Still though, good size truck. All right, guys, hey, that's my initial impressions here just from unboxing these trucks. I cannot wait to run these. I know that our drivers at Trigger King, we cannot wait to run these. So just bear with us a little bit here for a couple weeks, get our next event in here. I'm gonna be running them in the meantime, also working on my BigSquidRC.com review. You will see a full video review of these trucks. And you'll see video, otherwise of them as well, because we're gonna freestyle and do some other things with them. You'll find them in our regular Trigger King videos as well, but they will have a dedicated video review. There'll be a lot more impressions by then. And also the Trigger King drivers are going to share their impressions too. The guys who are better at racing, better freestylers, just everybody is going to try and share their opinions. Everybody wants to weigh in on these trucks. So, all right guys, hey, thank you very much for watching. We really appreciate you here on Trigger King as we approach 50,000 subscribers. It's crazy the success that this channel has had. We really, really appreciate it. We appreciate our manufacturer support. We wouldn't be getting these from Sen to test if not for all you guys out there. So again, big, big thank you to all you out there. Big thanks to Sen Racing for sending these to us. We will see you really, really soon here on the channel.